super, super happy and grateful to be here with you guys today. Happy and excited to see everyone on the call, see some familiar names, new names. I love to see it. Let's go ahead and run it up. Guys, as you guys know, this call is open as well to the public, so send this call out to anyone and everyone that may benefit from it. And I look forward to seeing new faces and familiar faces as well every week. Let's keep running it up. So, great way to start the week. It's no coincidence that we scheduled this call for at the beginning of the week, you know. So this is honestly something that I look forward to now, running on the weeks with you guys. Something that I've really enjoy spending time, and it's honestly like a very, very easy and comfortable thing to do, honestly. I remember when I was first running these calls, or when I first even started running a call period, I used to get way nervous, but now it's like super easy, comfortable to run a call and be here with you guys. So yeah, Matthew, are you here with us, brother?
Yo, I am. What's going on, everybody?
What's good, bro? What's up? What's good? How's your weekend going?
What's good? It's going pretty good, man. You know, I'm out here. I'm grateful to be here. Yeah, super. Honestly, that's really it. Shout out to everybody.
For us. So, you know, today we actually have a pretty interesting topic, bro. I believe that every call is kind of related to the previous one in a way. So we're going to be going off of like the previous call. So if you haven't already seen that call or heard that call, it is uploaded on the Beyond Your Beliefs channel. All calls are going to be uploaded on there. So guys, if you haven't already listened to it, go ahead and tune into that previous episode. And like I said, every episode is going to be leading on to the next. So it's very beneficial for you to listen to all of them. And in order too, I believe that these are going to be helping you grow your understanding of your beliefs, of what we see and our understanding as well. So, you know, this is to benefit us all and to increase our value, not just in each other, but, you know, in our lives and the people around us. So with that said, guys, today's topic, right, was the embodiment of success. Okay, and so, you know, Matthew, you know, I wanted to ask you this, and I know I've asked you this a couple of times already, and I really enjoyed your answers throughout, you know, the time that we've been working together. And Matthew's been somebody that has opened my perspective quite a bit. So I'd love to see, and thank you for sharing that link, and I'd love to hear your personal belief in what success is, because as you guys know, what you guys set that belief of what success is to you is a huge reflection of what your journey is going to be like. And so hear Matthew talk about his definition of success and what his belief is of what success looks like to him.
Yeah, so for me, you know, growing up personally, you know, I guess I never really had a good definition for myself on what success truly was. You know, I feel like really seeing, you know, athletes or actors or artists or whatever it was, I felt like, you know, being really good at something, you know, was really like success. And, you know, along the way, you know, you know, you get a little older and, you know, you see people with materialistic things and, you're like, oh, like that's a successful person. And, you know, for me, that's really what success was for a little bit, like really a perception, you know, they say back to your beliefs, you know, our perception is our reality. And for me, you know, I really want to keep things simple and straightforward. And something that I came across that you may have heard so many times from many successful people, things that I came across, you know, after listening to people like Napoleon Hill and, you know, Earl Nightingale and, you know, Bob Proctor and, you know, people like this, the thing that stuck out to me that made the most sense that I really resonated with is, to answer the question finally, right? Success is the progressive realization of a worthy ideal, right? So of a worthy idea, of a worthy goal, right? Mm-hmm. So, you know, I truly believe getting clear on what success means to you is very important, right? Meaning what is worthy for you, you know, to focus your time, you know, your energy, you know, what is worthy, you know, what is, you know, you could say meaningful, what is really worth it, right? So to me, success is the progressive realization of a worthy ideal, right? Of a worthy goal. That's really what it is. So I feel like, you know, from studying successful people and, you know, experiencing things myself is, you know, success is having goals, right? It really is having goals and progressively realizing them, because the more you immerse yourself in the things that you do, you know, you start to identify and explore new things that allow you to have more goals, which means, you know, we get to experience more success because we're in it, you know, we're doing something that is, you know, fulfilling to us. So yeah, for me, it's really just having a goal that is worthy to you and doing it, right? Meaning, and that's pretty much what it is for me. So that's the first thing. I know there's a few other things that, you know, we're going to get into talking about that I'd love to touch up on, but yeah, really straightforward. That's pretty much what it is for me. So, you know, it could be anything for you. I feel like it's really, it's like, I always say, you know, just like the title of these calls, you know, how they say there is no good or bad, but thinking is making it so. I truly believe in the same thing as right or wrong, you know, because it's really anything can be put into there. You know, everybody, you know, has different goals and whatever it is. So I truly see it as a formula that anybody could implement for themselves. So your goal could be anything. And as long as you have identified what is worthwhile for you and you are progressively realizing it, which means you are doing the things that you have to do in order to experience that, right? Meaning someone's goal could be to be the best mother they could possibly be for their children, right? And if they're doing the things to be that, then I truly believe that person is a success. You know, someone who's going to school to become a teacher because they genuinely want to be there for the youth and next generation to help them and to really just, you know, contribute and grow and be a part of that. And they're going to school, you know, progressively realizing and pursuing that goal, that idea that is worthy to them, then to me, that person is a success. So, you know, I truly believe it comes down to being and doing, right? Being and doing. So, you know, because if this is a worthy idea, if this is a worthy goal, then that means you've decided, right? Let me press this really quick. Right. You've decided what's worthwhile, what's meaningful, what's a worthy idea, what's a worthy goal to pursue for yourself. That's it truly is a reflection of us and who we are, because everything that we do, right, there is our behavior is an expression of our beliefs, right? So meaning if we truly believe in something, if that is our core beliefs, then we're pursuing it. Just like how we, you know, talked about recently and how, you know, we'll continue to talk about it is, you know, the things we experience is a result of our behavior, and our behavior is a result of the, you know, the thoughts and the feelings that we have, right? Our belief systems, our, our paradigms or our set of mental programs that control our habitual behavior, you know, who we are expresses what we do. So the things that we do create our experiences, right? That's our success. That's our goal, no matter what type of feedback we get back. So it really comes down for me is, okay, if this is my goal, if this is what's meaningful to me, then that means I must do the things, right? I have to do, right? Because that's, I believe that's who I am. Because if I truly believe that's who I am, then I automatically express that behavior, and I automatically do those things because that's who I am and that's what I do. And if that is my goal, then I am a success. So, you know, it's really a reminder to you, you know, that as long as you have goals and you're progressively realizing them and moving towards those things, you are a success, right? Like, I want to remind you that if you are progressively realizing goals, worthy ideas, things that are meaningful to you, you have already embodied success, right? Because it's just being, doing, and having, right? Things that are meaningful to you and all of that. So, you know, that's why I really love that, you know, you made that the title of this episode, Bastian, is the embodiment of success. Because, you know, many people, you know, they may be experiencing things along the journey where it's like, oh, why aren't things happening? But you continue in that vibration of believing in yourself and the things that you're pursuing that are meaningful to you, and you're doing the things you have to do to experience those things, you are a success, right? And, you know, for me, another thing that really correlates with success is enjoying it, right? Is having a good time and really taking time to be present and enjoy things. Because many times, you know, there could be a perceived gap, right? And I'll really end it with this. This is something Bob Proctor said. I feel like it's very powerful, right? Is all you need to know is where you are and where you're going, right? Many times, you know, words or beliefs can be very limiting to where you truly believe you're going, because many times someone could see themselves where they are and it's like, oh, I can't wait until this or until that, until I can do this, until I can do that. When in reality, like, most of the things we want to do, we really can do them now, progressively realize and pursue worthy goals and ideas. So it's really closing that gap, and you're here, you know, you're already there. You are already a success, you know? So for me, that's what success is to me. It's progressive realization of a worthy idea, of a worthy goal. So I appreciate you guys letting me share that with you. Thank you, Bastian. Yeah,
That's cool. Thanks for sharing that with us, you know, and just to add in a little bit to that, you know, wow, you know, first off, thank you. Like I said, I've always, you know, said this, and I've valued your perspective a lot. So in regards to like success, you know, for me, success has always been something that, and a lot of you may relate to this, has been something that may be a little bit more difficult to define, you know, and that's all right. Like, it doesn't have to be crystal clear. And one thing I want to clarify is that success is not linear. Okay, success is definitely not linear. You know what I mean? Like,
you can think it's gonna go just straight up. Like, everything is just different experiences along the way. So it's very powerful.
Yeah. Success is not linear. Like, we experience success and many failures along the way to success. And that's the reality of it. It's like, we all experience those things. And you have to understand that it's not that you have to experience those failures, but you get to experience those failures. It's nothing that you have to do. It's something that you now get to do, because you are heading towards down a journey that, and we read this all the time in our industry, for all of us who do trade, and 90 to 95% above 90% success rate, like a failure rate in our industry. And so you guys gotta understand, it's like there's a reason why many people quit and gave up on trading, and it's because of their belief in success. It goes really deep down to the belief of success, what their success was on a day-to-day basis, what you feel like, you know, your goals are long-term, short-term, and do your goals align to with your values? Because honestly, if your goals have little to do with your values, you're going down a path that may be very painful, because it's gonna be unfulfilling heading down a path in which you're setting up goals that don't line up to your values. You know what I mean? Go ahead, Matthew.
Yeah, I feel like that's literally like what you're saying is so powerful, because you know, I'm sure many people have heard this. It's not, you know, what you get. It's truly like who you become, you know, in the process. And, you know, I feel like it's very important, like goals and things that you have, you know, they really are an expression. Like everything has, you know, something behind it. And truly the person you become in the process, you know, throughout those failures, throughout those experiences, and, you know, especially as you start to, you know, get closer to things that are more meaningful to you, like it really has a huge impact on the way you think and, you know, the way you feel towards certain things. And it really shifts your belief system, you know, really going through that journey, because, you know, you're really going into the unknown. You know, you're really going into the unknown when you're pursuing something you've never had or like experienced before, like, you know, and you're able to gather information, and it really does shift, you know, who you are. And I feel like that's really what it does is, you know, when you're in the unknown, you really, it's about the person you're becoming. And yeah, that obviously expresses our success and whatever that is to us. So keep going, bro, please.
Yeah. And it's just like how you said, it's not about what you're going to get in the end. It's all about who are you becoming in the process? Who are we becoming in the end? Like, what is this journey going to do for you? And honestly, and this is something that I'm sure we could all relate to. How many of us came into this industry wanting financial freedom or hitting a monetary goal and are now realizing that this is more about you than it is about the money? This is more about you and self-discovery than it is about, you know, that financial freedom alone. And yeah, not saying that the financial freedom is still not the goal. Of course it is, right? It's one of the goals in there. But now you are starting to understand, or we get to understand ourselves a lot better. And so what this road to success, this embodiment to success, what it does is it will open up and expose sides of you that you may not be used to, sides of you that you may not feel comfortable having other people see. You may not feel comfortable even seeing that yourself, okay? But trading is truly an exposure, not just of the, you know, we don't just expose ourselves to the market, but it's an exposure of, you know, of ourself, of our true selves. And the way we handle our emotions, the way we handle our day-to-day, the way we handle our decisions. Because like Jim Rohn once said, you know, everything matters. You know, everything matters. You're not just a trader from 9 a.m. Eastern till, you know, 12 Eastern. Like, that's the reality of it. It's like, we can't just put on this mask for 3-4 hours and be a traitor. It's, we are that person. We are becoming that person always. You become that individual all the time. And so when the market is showing you that you feel like maybe you're incorrect against the market, maybe you feel like the market is showing you, you know, clarity. Maybe you feel like the market is not showing you clarity. Maybe it's a little bit more confusing today. What it's telling you, these signals are telling you, hey, like, take these signals and ask yourself, what lesson is to be learned from this? Because to embody success, we have to go through our failures. We get to go through our failures. Now we're going to change the word have to now get. We get to go through these things because there's a lesson. And I don't know what you guys believe in. And, you know, frankly, it doesn't matter what you believe in. It's, you know, whether it's a higher power or whether it's God, whether it's the universe, you know, I believe personally that, and I'm going to refer to him as God, right? So I believe that God has a plan for all of us and that we are being guided, right? If I pray for more wisdom, you know, I'm going to be given problems to solve instead of more wisdom, right? We don't ever get what we want. We get it things in a way where we receive the ability to grow in that aspect, right? So for example, if I'm asking for more wisdom, then I will find more problems. I will see more problems to solve. Then my wisdom will grow. If I'm praying for more love, I will, you know, there's a beautiful quote. If I prayed for love and God sent troubled people, troubled individuals for me to help. And I believe that's so beautiful because it can be applied to anything, right? So now switching that over to I'm praying for more success. I'm praying for more success. Therefore, God was going to hand you more failures to overcome, right? You pray for success. We ask for more success. Therefore, you will get more failures to overcome. You will face more failures than anybody else in this industry. It's one of the highest rates of failures in any industry, in any career path. And that's the reality of it. That isn't to be scared of. That is to understand that because there's so much failure in here, there's so much to learn from it. So to get to the next level, to get to closer to your success, we have to, or get to now, we get to go through these failures. And always ask yourself, what lesson is there to be learned here? What lesson is, because the only reason that you're not getting to the next level or closer to that next goal is because you probably haven't learned the lesson that God has ready for you or the universe has prepared for you to learn. So trust me, as soon as you learn that lesson, acknowledge that lesson, and apply it to your life, you will begin to vibrate at a higher level that's going to be closer to your success. Right? So honestly, that's to me what success, like in a really long answer, what success is. It is the way, it is what we ask. It is the asking. And failure is the receiving. What begins the receiving is the asking process, right? So praying for success, you will face many failures. But that's what you need. That's what we get. I don't know if you want to add on to that, Matthew.
I just feel like it's so powerful, and you did like a really good job in sharing how it correlates with how success is not linear, you know. It's like, and I love how you use the example where it's like, you know, many, so it's like, it just reminded me of like one of the quotes that I saw was like, you know, many people pray for cake, but, you know, complain when, you know, God gives them, you know, the ingredients and, you know, the instructions on how to bake it and stuff. And I feel like there's definitely things, you know, that we've been able to experience where, you know, we have these huge goals and, you know, this definition of success. And I truly believe success is progress, you know, success is continuously moving, right? Like it's progress. And, you know, just like on your equity curve, you know, there's, you know, as long as you're consistent, right? You're in the grand scheme, your losses are really small. And, you know, I just love like what you said. And it just reminded me of this other one where it's right, where it says, you know, I asked for strength and God gave me difficulties to make me strong. Right. So I asked for wisdom and God gave me problems to solve. Right. I asked for prosperity. God gave me brawn and brains to work. Right. I asked for courage and God gave me dangers to overcome. Right. I asked for patience and God placed me in situations where I was forced to wait. I asked for love. I prayed for love and God gave me troubled people to help. I asked for favors and God gave me opportunities. I received nothing I wanted. I received everything I needed and my prayers have been answered. Right. So, you know, I feel like it's also serves as another reminder of, you know, especially, you know, with which if you're experiencing this process of growth, right? Success is growth. It's, you know, progress. If things aren't, may not seem like they're coming as quick to you, I feel like it's because success for you and these goals are so meaningful that the things that you're praying for, asking for, they're so valuable that in correlation, right? In order for us, in order for you to experience those things, there's just a certain process that we're growing through, right? I believe we grow through things, right? All of the, you know, the journey of success, you know, the ups and downs, right? Just like the markets, right? Big distributions, there are opportunities for what? More accumulation. Like truly, in the grand scheme, like everything is building us, right? It's getting us closer to where we're headed. So, you know, I feel like trading is a very powerful thing that we all can, you know, relate to. And if someone's listening to this and you don't trade, so I feel like trading is very powerful because, you know, you get feedback and you continue to get more opportunities, right? You get the opportunity to continue progressing and growing. And I feel like that's what makes success enjoyable, you know, because maybe you have something, you know, there's different types of goals, right? We could get into that maybe on another episode, but, you know, there's A-type goals, B-type goals, C-type goals. A-type goals are, you know, goals that things that you've done and you know you can do, right? And B-type goals are things you think you can do. And C-type goals are like, holy, like, how am I going to do that? You have no idea, but you're willing to go into the unknown and grow through the process of realizing that success for yourself, because I truly believe it's more meaningful growing through something and learning things along the way. And I feel like that's just what makes it more enjoyable, you know, is understanding and having those constant reminders of a driver of why you're doing something. As long as you have that driver of why you're doing something, regardless of the ups or downs, you know, everything is temporary. Literally, you know, there's this quote, right? It's failure or success is not final and failure is not fatal. You know, so I feel like that's something that definitely helps us knowing that success is not final and failure is not fatal. Things are constantly moving. Things are constantly evolving. And as long as we're constantly moving and evolving, you know, I think we're going to be okay. You know, we'll be successful for a very long time. So...
I like that. I like that a lot. You know, success is not final, failure is not fatal. And sometimes it may feel like it. I don't know. Matthew, have you ever been in situations where you're like, man, like some levels of some failures may feel detrimental, and you know, and maybe we indulge ourselves a little bit too much in the now with those failures, and maybe not enough in the now, I guess, and more in like the past and the future consequences of those failures, that they may actually trigger a fatal feeling that you're like, oh shit, like I blew it, you know what I mean? And I don't know if that's happened to you. I know it's happened to me recently as well. That is a huge, huge nugget. If you guys didn't write that down, you know, success is not final, failure is not fatal, right? And here's something that diving back into the embodiment of success is being and doing. Okay, so Matthew actually, before we started the call, sent me a note, and I'm reading this pointer because this is the part where I was really intrigued to hear what he had to say, because being and doing, that is, to me at least, being is becoming, right? And then doing, I don't know, it to me is doing. I this is something that I want to focus on more, and I am focusing on a lot more this year, is talking a lot less and doing a lot more, becoming a lot more by doing a lot less. And I want to hear what your thoughts are, Matthew, on this pointer that you sent me, because this is the one that really truly intrigued me.
Yeah, and I feel like that's something that we talk about a lot, and I feel like it's something that we continuously, you know, learn more and more about, you know, as we go. And you know, I'm very grateful to continue like returning to this, because I feel like there's new things that we learn about it and its correlation and relationship to us and the things we experience, things that we do, as we continue to focus on it, because there's just a new level of awareness that we continue to have around it. And I truly believe it's as simple as just having an honest, extremely honest look and ask yourself, right? Because I truly believe it's not about the answers you receive. It's really in the quality of the questions that you're asking. Like that's really where you're going to find things. So when it comes to being and doing, you really have to ask yourself, right? What is it that you truly want, right? Who are you, right? Like, what do you want? Why do you want it? Like, what are you doing, most importantly? And why do you do it? That's really what it is, right? Is what are you doing? Why are you doing it, right? Because that's a successful person. And anything that they do, they're doing it, and there's a reason behind why they do it. People who want to become successful, they want to do something. You know, they're waiting. So I truly believe it's just taking an honest look and being like, if I already am, right? You have to perceive yourself as if you already are the successful version of yourself. Then you must already be doing the things that successful version of yourself does in order to, right, experience the things you experience, right? So that's why that's the truth of like who we are is what we do and why we do it. So I you know, it's really, this is just, I'm just really thinking, because there's so many times where I felt like I really wanted something, but that I wasn't operating from a version of myself that was already successful. The successful version of myself does those things and experiences those things. So like when you close that gap that we talk about and shift the paradigm to, you already are successful, you are that person, you are that version of yourself now because you do those things, right? Successful people don't become extremely successful on accident, right? They believe in themselves so much, right? Our behavior, the actions that we do, the things that we do are an expression of our beliefs. So when we believe in something so much, ourselves, our goals, we automatically do it, right? Our they call it the burning desire, right? The driving force of your belief level, of your belief system towards this idea of this goal. Our actions are automatically like in alignment with what we say we want, of what we do and why we do it. So I believe it's just taking an honest look and, you know, saying, okay, if this is truly what I want, if this is truly who I am, then that means I must be doing the things that person does. Because if I don't, then I am contradicting the success that I truly believe I deserve. And we only get what we deserve. So.
I like that. Being and doing. That's, honestly, that's a gap that I have, you know, that I haven't reached yet. This is where visualization and meditation really comes in. You know, and you guys are going to hear me say this a lot, have heard me say this a lot probably, but if you don't have just 5 to 7 minutes, oh, my microphone is so low. Let me get a little closer to it. Okay. If you don't have, you know, 5 to 7 minutes of, you know, if you don't have, if you can't set aside 5 to 7 minutes for you, for yourself, or it's 5 to 7 minutes, you know, we schedule meetings with each other, we schedule meetings with other individuals, we schedule meetings, you know, we schedule time to trade, we schedule time to study, we schedule time to learn from other individuals, we schedule time to work, we schedule time to go hang out. But, and this is something that I have added on, that's been on my schedule for almost a year now, okay? And it's an hour a day, and yours doesn't have to be an hour. It can be, again, mine started as 5 minutes. It can be time for you. How many of us have actually set time for ourselves? Okay, and this is a huge moment of self-reflection. Okay, huge moment of self-reflection, because if you're not spending 5 to 7 minutes with yourself, with your own thoughts, by yourself, there may be something there that's keeping you from wanting to learn from you, right? Maybe you don't see yourself as that successful individual, right? Maybe that's why you don't make time for you, for yourself, to be with your own thoughts, right? But I want you guys to challenge yourselves this week and make 5 to 7 minutes out of your day to just sit in your thoughts, okay? And I want you guys to take notes of this, okay? So close your eyes when you're thinking, when you have those 5 to 7 minutes in an area where you're gonna be no disruptions. Set your phone to do not disturb, or, you know, go in a room with no electronics, okay? Have some you time, okay? And I want you to close your eyes when you do this. And And this is super powerful practice, okay? This is the art of letting go. This is how we let go of failures and welcome lessons, okay? So sit in a room, close your eyes for 5 to 7 minutes and watch your thoughts come, okay? Imagine yourself, you're sitting in your mind, and your mind is this giant highway, okay? And you're watching cars or your thoughts pass by, come and go, okay? Go from one direction to the other. And as your thoughts come, okay, acknowledge it, know it's coming, be aware of it, and also practice on letting it go. Okay, so we're gonna take deep breaths and we're going to acknowledge our thoughts, okay? Because we can't just not think. It's impossible. We're always gonna have thoughts coming through. Okay, even when we go blank, it's when thoughts flood, or when we indulge in one thought very deeply. So close your eyes, envision yourself at the highway of your mind, and your thoughts are just going through like vehicles. Some vehicles may be more outstanding than others. Some vehicles you may not find so attractive, right? Some vehicles may be a lot louder than others. Okay, some of your thoughts maybe lingering around or going a lot slower than your other thoughts. But the practice, the goal is to just watch them come, acknowledge it, and let it go. Let that thought go. And I promise you, 5 to 7 minutes of this every day, okay, will give you a huge, huge amount of self-reflection for the rest of your life. And this is something that the art of letting go is something that you'll be able to apply to anything. How many of us have struggled to let go of a trade? I know everybody that's on here that does trade, or anybody that has a business or has made a business decision or at work, any decision at all, and you have a hard time letting go of that emotion, thought, feeling, or experience. Maybe it was a really big opportunity to you. Maybe it was a big deal to you. But whether it's good in your perspective or bad, practice letting go. Let go of the good thoughts. Let go of the negative ones. The healthy and unhealthy, okay? So we're gonna refer to good or bad as healthy or unhealthy. So let go of the healthy thoughts, the healthy experiences, the exciting ones. And also learn to let go of the detrimental ones, the ones that seem fatal, right? The ones that you may not like as much, but are still lingering around.
I'll also add on to two other words as well to add on to those is ones that are serving you and ones that aren't.
That's big. Is this serving me? Is this serving successful me?
I also feel like embodying success, especially just goes with what you're sharing is, beginning success is really like a journey of acceptance, like you really learn to accept things and move forward. I feel like it's, successful people really, really accept things that take place and move forward, as best as they can. And as long as you know you're doing everything you can, you've made peace with things that have happened or things that are happening, and you progressively move forward towards that goal, towards that idea, then
yeah,
there's no stopping you.
Yeah, that's very true, very factual. And that's You know, this is going to be our segment of embodying success. And there's one last thing that we're going to end it with, and it's enjoy it. Okay? Find joy in your process, because that's where your success lies, is in the process. Find joy in everything that you do. Okay? Find joy in every trade. Find joy in every experience. There's a book. Okay, there's a book that I've read this year, and I've been recommended this book for so long, and I wish I would have read it before, but now I'm super, super grateful that I did. It hit me hard because it was so relatable. And the book is The Greatest Salesman in the World. Okay. And I read that this year, and then, man, that book, so powerful. But one of the laws that, and I'm not going to ruin this whole thing for you guys. So one of the laws that they talk about in the book, okay, is I'm going to give you two of them. And one of them is, I am nature's greatest miracle, and nature knows no defeat. Okay? So I am nature's greatest miracle, and great nature knows no defeat. Okay? And the other law is, I will greet every day with love in my heart, and for that I will succeed. So greeting every moment, not just every day, but every moment with love and understanding, I am nature's greatest miracle. I am success. I am that successful individual, and receiving that with love, receiving those thoughts with belief, a strong belief that that's who you are. You are love. You are a miracle. It is a miracle for us to be here. We're a miracle to share this moment together. This is a miracle just being here with one another, experiencing this moment. It is a miracle waking up every single day. It is a miracle learning information. You are nature's greatest miracle. You are God's greatest miracle and gift, right? Every day, receive it with love. Every moment, receive it with love. Every trade, every business decision, receive it and acknowledge it with love. Whether you perceive it as a healthy or unhealthy trade, healthy or unhealthy business decision, healthy or unhealthy goal, right? Just receive that moment with love. You will gain the most out of every moment, acknowledging the love behind it. There's love in everything. You know, there's, and I don't know if you guys have ever heard of this book, but it's by, it's called Conversations with God. Okay, I'm sure you guys can find the audio on YouTube. I highly, highly suggest, that's a book that, yes, you can read it, but highly, highly suggest, it's much more touching
and awesome. Wow. I could just say those, just wow about that book.
Get that book. That book will show, will explain a little bit more, but it's all about these two emotions in which everything, in which life derives from. And it's, you're either moving in love or you're moving in fear. Love or fear. There's no other two. You're either moving with love or you're moving in fear. And that's the reality of it. This is what those 5 to 7 minutes are going to show you. Whether you're moving in love or you're moving in fear. And these are things that we must reflect on, that we get to reflect on. Because why? We get to reflect on these things to see how much closer we are to our goals, to our level of success, and enjoying those moments, receiving every single moment with love, and learning how to move with love. You move towards everything with love. We do things for love. That, right? And so that's the note we're going to leave it on. And I want you guys to focus on that. Okay? And give yourself that affirmation every day. Every day when you wake up this morning or tomorrow, today, to wherever it is that you're at in the world, whenever it is that you're listening to this, tell yourself that affirmation. I will receive and greet every day with love. I will greet every day with love. Every time you get to wake up another day, that's love. That's love waking you up. Every time you get to spend another moment with your loved one, that's love. Every time we get to get on the charts together in the mornings or in the night, that's love right there. There's nothing else that moves that but love. We're not fearfully going in the markets. We're moving towards it with love. And love, you know, success to me is love. Now, love is success to me. And I enjoy every single day love. And therefore, because we take joy in everything that we do and receive every moment with love, you are embodying that success. I can honestly tell you guys, I've met some very successful people in my life, and so they were some of the most loving individuals and most giving individuals. They were, you know, and it's beautiful to see that. That when you move with love, you are able to receive everything with love. When you receive things with love, then you will find the joy in life, the joy in everything that we do. And that's the reality of it. Win every day. If you're indulging in love, you're winning. And that in itself is success. That in itself is success. So find success, right? Love in all that you do and acknowledge it for the love that it's giving you, the lessons that it's teaching you, the experiences that you're feeling, and win. These daily wins, that's a win. When you wake up and give yourself affirmation, that's a win. When you wake up another day, that's a win. When you take a small red day, that's a win. That's success. A lot of us came into this industry and blew accounts, blew like 20% in one trade, 10% in one trade. Right? Now look at all of us. Our level of success, our progress, that's love right there. That's a win. Coming and showing up to the classes, that's a win. That's small wins that compound on top of each other. And the compound is the eighth wonder of the world. So compound these wins. Small wins will compound over the period of time. Okay, so we'll win.
Sorry.
Go ahead, brother.
I feel like, yes, like literally, yes, those are all wins. And I believe winning is just a way of being, you know, being successful is a way of life. And it's not just like a one-time thing, like, oh, I hit this now, like I'm successful. Like, again, it goes back to who you are. And I feel like I really resonate with what you shared about successful people. I'll never, or at least, you know, this is like this, there's a limiting belief right there, right? Saying I'll never remember everything, but like, that's our memory is a whole nother paradigm and, you know, things like that. And I truly, you know, I've heard and I've studied and known that we do have perfect memories, just, you know, focus and things that we choose to remember is just, it's in there, you know, it's somewhere. Because our subconscious mind is always constantly downloading things, but that's another episode, right? We'll go into that later. is that I'll never really remember everything they said, but I'll never forget how they made me feel. That is, and this is a feeling I've had the pleasure, the honor Bastion has as well. And Bastion, I know you know what I'm talking about, bro. You know, like, we've had the honor, the pleasure to be surrounded by people with billion-dollar net worths. But that had nothing to do. Like, they didn't have a 10-figure mark, like, on their, like, shirt or anything. Like, I'm a billionaire or nothing. It's just the conversation didn't even go about, like, oh, I make this much. None of that. It's much more beyond that. And that's something that successful people understand, is everything is energy. And you really get what you give. And, you know, if there's anything that you could take away from operating from successes, you know, it's share love, just like Bastion said, you know, share love, share that energy, because from our experiences, we've noticed that you truly do get what you give. And the extremely successful people we've been able to be around have been some of the most genuine, loving, caring individuals like we've ever met. Facts. You know, I'll never really remember everything they've said, but I will never, ever forget how they made me feel. Welcoming,
facts,
valued, appreciated. Mm. So grateful, you know? So you are successful.
It's true. It's very true. Like you said, being in the presence of the individuals, you truly understand, like, you begin to understand what it's really all about. There's been plenty of times that I met with some of these individuals, and right after, I'm just like, you know, like, deleting messages, clearing chats. I'm just like, my focus gets open, my perspective becomes more open to, like, realizing what deserves my energy and what doesn't. Because honestly, these individuals truly embody success. They show you their true interests in you, and you don't see these things. Like, there's no way that I would be able to tell that somebody's a billionaire or anything like that, other than by the way they carried themselves and their energy and presence, the way that they listened. Because there's not one that has ever been super or has ever been judgmental. They're all super warm and welcoming. And so they move with love. That's love. Love all things and all beings, every moment, every experience. That's success. That's a win. And these wins compound over time. So with that, guys, we are going to wrap it up. And, you know, want to let you guys know I'm super grateful for everybody being here. Thank you for sharing this moment with us and this conversation. Appreciate every single one of you for tuning in from last week, coming back this week. All of our new individuals as well, welcome. I imagine and I have faith that I'll see you guys on the next call as well. We won't be running the call next Sunday, but we will see you guys on the 24th of July. Okay, on the 24th of July, we'll see you guys at the same time. Again, thank you guys. Thank you guys for everything. Thank you guys for your presence, for your love. Let's keep moving with love. Let's greet every single day with love, every single moment, every single experience, and you will get the most out of it. Make some time for yourself, and you know, I will see you guys on the next.
Thank you, guys.